All right, guys, the next one is update contacts. So this will be a public void method. We'll name it update contacts. Contact. The update contact will take a contact as the argument. Right, so by now you're used to it. The first thing you do is you create a SQLite database object. This time we are writing, so it will be get writable database. Next, we want to use our content values object once again. So content values values is equals to new content values. Now, what we will be putting in the content values is just the same things we're putting if we're adding a contact, except, let me go back to that method so we remind ourselves. So here's our add contact method. So we want to do the exact same thing so that we can update our contact, except we will not be adding a new ID. The ID is what will stay the same. What we will change is perhaps the person's name, the person's number, etc., etc. So let's do that. In fact, what we'll do is we'll copy. No need to type code twice. Work smart, not hard. There we go. So those are that's our content values. And then all we have to do is, actually, before I go on, let's change this. Let's change this from a void. Let's change this from a void return type to an int return type. So it's going to return us an int. This is because the method that we're going to use to update is called db.update. That one. And if the update operation is successful, db.update will return us a number. It will return 1 if it's successful or 0 if it's not. So we can say return db.update, and then inside we can pass the table, which is contacts table, our values, and the rest can be null. So once we update, if the update works successfully, this method will return the number 1. So we could do a simple if statement if once we are using it. Let me just type down here to demonstrate. We could say if, and then we could return, rather we could test update contact. And we pass in the contact. For example, let's just say new contact for now. And then we say is equivalent to 1. Right? So we could do something like this, and then if it works, then we could pass a message. For example, we could say updated successfully. Or if it doesn't, if it gives us a 0, we could have an else clause that says or something, or some other meaningful error message. So that's what we could do. That's why we have this as an integer return type. Okay, so that's update contact. Now let's do delete contact. So this is public void delete contact. And the delete contact will also take in a contact as the argument. Let's just open this first. There we go. So, contact. As always, SQLite database DB is equals to get writable And then, as you might imagine, the method that we're using is db.delete. And you pass in the contacts table. Now, for this one, what we need is a where clause. We need to tell the method which one to delete. And to do this, it's just like when we're getting, we need to pass in the column as well as the clause. Let's see. Rather, the column and the equals to, what it should be equal to. So for this, we write ID, then we break into a string, is equal to question mark, just as we had for the getting the contact. The next thing we need is the what the question mark is equals to. So again, just like we did for the contact, so, and it has to be an array, even though it's just one value. So new string, then you put your braces and you write string dot value of, and then you take this contact that you passed in and you use the getter method to get its ID. So this will give the statement the ID to look for, to put in this question mark, and that the contact with that ID is the one that will get deleted. So that's the third argument, and that's actually all we need. So we can terminate and we can say db.close. And there you have it. Those are our update and delete methods. To make this a little neater, I'll just break it there, and then using the commas. So that and that. Okay, so that's my delete. So let's go through it just once more. Update contact. We get our SQLite database object, and then we create a content values object. And in this case, we are putting the column name and the value from the contact, just as if we were adding a new contact, except we don't put a new ID. So having put all the columns, the next thing we do is we return db.update contact tables. We put the values and we put, actually, I think I'm missing something because we haven't specified which one to change. So to do that, I put nulls. I don't know why. It's just a habit because I put lots of nulls in this project. So what it actually should be is, it should be, the second argument should be the where clause, just as we have here. I'll actually copy that. That's the where clause. And then the next one is our where argument, which again is just as we have here. So take that. And there we go. Okay, that's fine now. Yes. Nope. I just need to add a brace that matches up to that brace, and then a bracket. Okay, yes, that's fine now. Once again, I will break it down to keep it neat. So that and that, and then using the commas. So our values, our where clause, and our argument. Okay, there you go. So it will go to the contacts table, taking these values with it. Then it will look for the ID of the contacts and select the one that has the ID that you pass in through this contact, and it will update it. Very simple, very straightforward. Then next is the delete contact. Again, we create our SQLite object, our SQLite database object, then simply call db.delete contacts table, our clause, and finally our argument, and then db.close, and that is all.